Good morning, students. Welcome to Narayana Online Classes. Today we'll discuss the key for the assignment Light Reflection and Refraction of 16th June 10th class physics. Let us see the first question. What type of lens is called as magnifying glass? So if you just observe the magnifying glass is thick at the center. And the same magnifying glass is thin at the edges. So we can consider this magnifying glass as a convex lens, or it is a biconvex lens. As we consider the two sides of this magnifying glass are bulged out, so we are calling this as a biconvex lens, or simply it is a convex lens. So let us discuss the second question. Name the bending of light if the beam of light passes obliquely from one medium to another medium. So whenever we consider the two different media, and this is the interface of the two different media. So let us consider a normal. So if the ray of light is entering into the first medium to the second medium obliquely, so the bending of light takes place. So actually this is the original path of the light. So the bending of light takes place when light travels from one medium to the another medium. So we can call the phenomena of change in the direction of light or bending of light when light passes obliquely from one medium to another medium, this phenomena is called as refraction of light. It is called as refraction of light. Let us see the third question. What type of lens is this? So in the given figure, we can find the lens is thin at the center and thick at the edges. So we can name this lens as concave lens. And we can also see in this, the images formed by this concave lens are smaller than the object. And the images are always virtual, erect, and diminished. So we can say the lens is thin at the center and thick at the edges, then the lens is a concave lens, and the concave lens always forms virtual, erect, and diminished images. So the given lens is a concave lens. Let us see the fourth question. Is this a converging lens or a diverging lens? So if you see clearly in this picture, the parallel beam of light, whenever it gets refracted from this lens, the refracted rays are diverging from each other, and they are also diverging from away from the principal axis. So we can find they appear to diverge from a point known as focus. So in this kind of lens, we can find the nature is diverging nature. So we are calling this lens as diverging lens. So the given lens is a concave lens, so it is a diverging lens here. So all the parallel beam of light rays or the paraxial rays, after refraction, they appear to diverge from the focus. So we are calling this lens as a diverging lens. Let us see the fifth question. What is lens? So a lens is a image forming device and a lens is a transparent material that is bounded by the two curved surfaces. So this material is a transparent material like glass or any polymeric plastic, and it is bounded by the two curved surfaces. So the light will be getting refracted at these two curved boundaries or the two curved surfaces, and the image will be formed because of the refraction. So lens is an image forming device, and that is bounded by the two curved surfaces and made up of a transparent material where the image formation takes place after the refraction at these two bounded surfaces. Let us see the sixth question. What type of lenses has two sides that are both convex? So if we consider the two sides of the lens are bulged out or convex, we can call this lens as biconvex lens. The example for this biconvex lens is the magnifying glass. So let us see the next question, the seventh one. from which part of the lens the ray of light passes without deviation. For example, if we consider a convex lens or a concave lens, and this is the principal axis, the light passes through the optic center undeviated. So the ray that is passing through the optic center through any lens, either it is convex or concave, it passes undeviated. So there won't be any deviation in the light that is passing through the optic center of the lens, either concave or convex. So you can say the ray of light passes without deviation from the O is optic center. Let us see the next question, the 8th one. What type of lens has a center that is thicker than the edges? For example, if we consider a lens, the lens which is thick at the center compared to the edges are thin here, we can name this kind of lens as biconvex lens or convex lens. So even in the case of the plano convex lens also, we can expect the at the center the thickness is high compared to the edges. So either convex lens or biconvex lens will have the thick center and the thin edges. Let us see the next question, the 9th one. What type of lens has a center that is thinner than the edges? For example, if we consider a lens, at the center it is thin, but at the edges it is thick. We will name this lens as concave lens or biconcave lens. So in the concave lens or biconcave lens, we can expect the at the center the thickness is less compared to the edges. So here it is thinner at the center and it is thicker at the edges. So this lens is a concave lens. So let us see the last question, the 10th one. What type of lens has one side that is convex and the other side that is concave? For example, if we consider a lens, the one part of the lens is convex, the other part of the lens if we consider as concave, then the lens will be concavo-convex. So one side we are going to expect the concave and other side we are going to expect the convex for the lens. So that will be concavo-convex.